welcome to Digit, and this is the Sony Xperia XZ1. It has just been launched in India. It was first announced in IFA Berlin, of course. It's the upgrade to Sony's Xperia XZ, and almost everything remains the same with some additions. It's got a 5.2-inch FHD HDR display. It's got a 19-megapixel camera right here on the back. It runs on the Snapdragon 835 chipset, so it's one of the very few devices in India that actually run the Snapdragon 835. Sony has added a few new camera tricks this time. One of them, of course, is predictive capture. So you can just go into the predictive mode. It's usually set on auto by default. You can turn it off as well. What predictive capture does is when you click a photo, predictive capture takes four different photos of it, and then it gives you the option to choose between the best photo or, you know, the other photos. Another thing Sony has done is a predictive hybrid autofocus, where if you have a moving object, you can simply burst click, and it's a burst autofocus. So everything will be in focus and you can choose the best shot out of it. That is the other camera advancement that Sony has done. What Sony is touting on this phone is this, the 3D creator. So with the 3D creator, Sony allows you to create a face scan of a person. So you can simply scan a person or an object, and you can use it for other purposes. You can share it, you can print it on a 3D printer, on a connected 3D printer if you can get your hands on one, and you can use it for other purposes as well. For example, if I send you a photo of a toy or any showpiece, you can put it on your table and see how it works. The 3D scan can be checked on the phone as well, of course, and it seems like a very niche feature that, you know, very few people will use, because 3D printers themselves are expensive. But Sony's point is that this is now a portable device that can do 3D scans and then allow you to print. Overall, on first impressions, what has changed with the Xperia XZ1 is that it feels much more metallic this time. It was metal last time as well, but this one feels more premium and more, a tougher sort of metal. It's a very compact device with a 5.2-inch display. It's really compact. It's not perfectly suited for single-handed usage, but it's still okay for single-handed usage. If you really need to use it, you will be able to use it. Sony's cameras are usually good, but they have sort of lagged behind in terms of, comparing to Samsung's Note or the iPhone. But let's see how this one pans out. Again, on first impressions, it's a very premium device with a niche audience. We have to figure out how it works out. The Sony Xperia XZ1 will be priced at $44,990 and sells from today, September 25th, in stores.